Hello and welcome back to this Let's Play of Vampire the Masquerade Bloodlines with myself, Waze, and Jack. We are here in the Peep Show place. We managed to get rid of one of the guys from downstairs by locking it down, but we still have this guy who will not leave, despite standing in front of a shut down Peep Show hole. This place here is closed. The man upstairs said that the girls won't come out until everyone has left. So we need to wait for this guy to go. So what we're gonna do is, while we're having a look around upstairs, we didn't see anything. We didn't go in here, actually. We didn't see anything over here apart from lots of smutty videos. So let's have a look just to see if there's anything of, oh, hello, of note in here. Dirty dog. Okay, there has to be a password of some sort. Let's head back down to this little office down here and have a look at the old computer again and see if this gets us into... We couldn't get into the private messages before. Dirty dog. Accepted, yes. Big John Farmer. John's finally left the acting side and has begun to produce films. As expected, he's sticking to the farm stuff. He said to contact him at... Yeah, long telephone number. That guy needs help. Yeah, man, he really does. Is that it? That's all it gives us? Peep show, let's try that again. Let's try lockdown again. Although that guy's standing in front of a closed screen anyway. It got rid of the other one. Okay, window one is unavailable because it's broken. Two and three are both locked down. Let's go and see if that makes him leave. No, this guy is desperate. Dude, you need to get a life, man. Okay, look. Maybe we need to wait or something, but what we're going to do is, while Jack was having a look around up here, he was thinking more about this this tape. Ginger Swan. She's dead. What's his name? Isaac said something about people crying over her grave. So we're thinking, let's head back to the cemetery. Was that back down this way? And we didn't look through all of the cemetery. Oh, and I also figured out the thing. It's when I have a targeted power, it shows me who's actually targeted. Cemetery's not down here. So if I move it to something that acts on myself, then it disappears. So I know what that is now. Finally. So I've been meaning to look that up for ages. Now, where was the cemetery again? Still very fancy. Doesn't go anywhere or lead anywhere, though. Where are you going, Jack? Caroline's. You got a problem, dude? Are we gonna have a problem? You're lucky that I'm full. Out of the way. Yeah, lucky that I was full, because he was ripe for the taking. Now, where was the cemetery? Let me go and have a look at a map. As usual, Jack's sense of direction is not the best. Fastbark, cemetery 8. I'm there. So 4 is red spot. So that's to my right, so I need to go left. If I'm reading, if my map reading is correct. Is it down this way? Let's see. Oh, for God's sakes. I'll try around the other way. Yep. Okay, is that the wall of the cemetery? It is. Now, old Romero's back, so we should be safe enough from the zombies because he has his big gun and he's a much better shot than I am. Whoa, what's the noise? Wolves. Okay, we looked all down here. Or should I say, we looked up here. Yeah, because I remember Chad. We looked up here. We'll go and see Romero again as well. Yeah, we looked all around here. Down behind Romero's, we didn't because we got distracted by the job. Hey, Romero.
Oh, it's you. Doorman to the dead.
Oh, yeah, very funny. Very. I said I was sorry, man. Yeah, just remember who's immortal here. Okay, Romero doesn't want to talk anymore. Sounds like we got some werewolf friends. Right, swans. That's just another way into the same place. Nothing on these tombs. It has to be in the graveyard. I mean, it just... I don't see how... it can be anywhere else. Andrew Meggs. Merrill. Another Chad. Another Merrill. Are these just like brand names of tombstones, or are a lot of people with the same name? Oh, hello. Lots of names that I can't read. Go left. Been in there a while with those cobwebs. Oh, hello. What do we have here? Horror tape, a battered video cassette. The labeling is cheap and worn, you can barely make out. Devil Spawn Flesh Feast 1, and the logo, which looks somewhat like DMP. It appears this tape has changed hands more than a few times. This must be it. And we have experience. You have discovered the tape Isaac has been looking for, hidden in Ginger Swan's tomb. There we go. It is extremely worn, and the only discernible markings on it say Devil Spawn, Flesh Feast, and DMB. Bring the tape back to Isaac. Righty-ho. Good. Good. Which is the way out? Was it down here? Ah, well done, Jack. You managed to not get lost in the tomb. And yeah, we're back up this way, aren't we? Well, we have our tape. Let's find out what Isaac thinks of it. Firstly, though, let's go and go back and see if old pervy dude is still standing in front of a closed screen and see if it makes any difference. No, we got to try and figure out some way to make him leave. And I'm going the wrong way. Where's the hole in the wall? Right. How close are we? Fast buck. Yeah, the jeweler's is all the way down the other end, I think. Is it? Yeah, it is. So we will go. It was here, wasn't it? The Sin Bin. That was the peep show place. Right. Let's just speak to this
what
dude.
What can
again.
I do for you, Slick?
Got some questions for
you. Yeah? What do you want to know?
I just want to see. Oh, he's already told me about Hollywood. Is that it? No, nothing right now, I suppose. Anything else?
What can I do for you, Slick?
What am I missing here? Let me have a look at your stuff again. No. Don't want any of that. No. Flynn, you're pretty damn useless. In there, we got the password. Let's go and see if this dude is still there. Oh, come on, man. Hello? Oh, very nice. An envelope containing a bit of cash. $150. Don't mind if I do. Excellent. Still no one coming out of here. Oh. Dude. He's just not moving. That's locked down. That's locked down. Can't be opened. Yeah, because that one, number one's broken. Number two is locked down. I thought this was locked down as well. Let's go try that again. Whoa, a peep show. Lockdown. Okay, one's unavailable, two is locked down, three is locked down. Surely the guy has to leave. Status. They're saying they're. Okay, that's just operational or malfunctions. Okay. This guy has just got to leave. If he doesn't leave, I'm just going to have to take him out. But that's really. That's not what old Velvet Velour was looking for. Right, dude. Jack's thinking this to himself, not saying it out loud, but we're going to go and see Isaac and come back. And if this dude is still there, we're just going to have to take him out because I don't have the patience for this, to be honest. We need to somehow get rid of him, and then we need to think about how we're going to get rid of the other dancer because there's two of them in there. Right, Isaac, this way. Good on blood, good on health. Just need pervy dude to leave. And then we can try and take out Chastity the Hunter. But for once, we've managed to get hold of a tape without, or to do a quest without actually killing anyone. It's a strange feeling for Jack. It feels sort of good. As long as we've done it right and this is the tape, it seems like it is. Isaac.
Don't have it, do you?
All this for tape. They have this thing called online shopping now.
I didn't doubt you'd find this. Yeah. And I apologize if I was overly imperious before.
Just a bit.
A reflex action. I get a lot of young blood in here for getting their place. I'll assist you as reasonably as I can with your task. But first...
Oh, but first what?
This tape. I'm in a hurry to find out what's behind all the hype, so get comfortable. I do have a feeling that whatever's here may be of use to both of us.
Okay, dude, this is messed up. Death Mask Productions. Yeah, right.
It's more disturbing than I was led to believe. You can understand my concern now, can't you?
Yeah, that's fair enough, but it's a bit sick and everything. Why is it important to me?
It just so happens that around the time this snuff film started circulating, the Nosferatu disappeared. I tried to elicit their help in tracking down the source, and for the first time in all these years, I was dismayed by their absence.
Okay, so you think this is connected to them disappearing?
I assume it does. It's awfully coincidental otherwise. And those creatures. I don't know how many professional FX houses could pull those off. There's a problem, though, in that the film's incomplete. The first half is damaged. We need a complete copy.
Are you sick? I mean, you want to watch more of it? It's, I've paid my tribute. This is your problem. I was sent here to find the Nosferatu.
If you think you can find them without my assistance, the door is over there.
Oh, damn you. Right, fine. Where do we find a better copy?
Behind the spit-shine gloss of the Hollywood Dream Factory, there's another city churning out a vile byproduct for the furtive consumption of a debauched audience. I have no doubt the film's found its way to another smut peddler. I'd ask around.
Smut, right. Okay. I'll take a look around and ask some questions. I think I know a guy who might know something. Let's go talk to Flynn. He seems to be a guy who knows about smut. Okay. Back to the sin bin.
I'll scream.
Just scream all you want. Everyone's so bloody grumpy and aggressive around this town. Constantly and consciously paranoid now about walking past the places that I'm looking for. Right, let's talk to Flynn, see if he knows anything about this video.
What can I do for you, Slick?
Got a few questions for you, Flynn.
Yeah? What do you want to know?
You ever heard of Death Mask Productions?
Those guys? Yeah. Yeah, I heard of them. Why do you want to know?
I might be in the market for some of their products.
Really? You a cop?
Do I look like a cop? I'm just trying to get some information, man.
All right. Listen, I'll tell you a little bit, but if anyone comes asking, you never heard it from me. They produce only the most hardcore video. I'm not even talking black market here, more like black hole market. Not the kind of product you want to get mixed up in.
Okay, what do you mean? What kind of stuff are you talking about, Flynn?
The kind of stuff that gets you put in jail for just talking about it, all right?
Okay.
Snuff Films is just the tip of the iceberg. I only seen one of their videos, and I swear I couldn't eat for a week.
Yeah, if it's bad for you, you think it's real or just really good special effects?
Real enough that every cop in 5 states has been trying to track these guys down. They are bad news, pal. You want some advice from me? Stop thinking whatever you're thinking and get your ass back to Kansas.
Look, I've got this crazy tape. I need to find out if it's real.
A tape? You mean the tape? You've got a copy of it? Have you seen it?
Maybe.
Look, man, get the hell out of here, all right? I don't want any part of that scene. I hear people seeing that tape ain't been coming home for dinner. I don't deal in that kind of stuff anyway, so just take it somewhere else.
Man, I thought this place had everything. Come on, you gotta know something, man.
Forget it, man. I don't even know what the hell you're talking about. Huh? What? Who are they? Seriously, get the hell out of here.
Nah, come on. Look, let's talk cash.
Cash? Well, that changes things a little. But we're talking about some pretty hot info here. Underground stuff, you know? Like the kind of info that $500 might get you.
$500? I do not have that kind of green, man.
Then I ain't got nothing else to say about it.
Come on.
Yeah? What do you want to know?
I need to find Death Mask Productions.
Forget it, man. I don't even know what the hell you're talking about. Huh? What? Who are they? Seriously, get the hell out of here.
Come on, you won't tell me anything?
No way, man. No, either you buy something or get out of here.
All right, later, dude. Damn. Damn, damn, damn. Let's go and see if Pervy Guy's gone. Oh, you have got to be kidding me. How can you still be here? cleared that out. Maybe if I let him see something, he'll go. Okay, there's chests here anyway. And there's the other one. I think there's only two of them in there. Dude! Can't talk to him, can't do anything. Jack is really trying hard to hold his patience here because he's, all he wants to do is just kill the guy. I don't know. That's the exit. Come on, what am I gonna do? Is he gonna leave? Have I messed something up somewhere along the way here? Oh god, I didn't mean to go outside. That's frustration button pressing. How do I get rid of this guy? Right, let's go back in. Come on. That has to shut down, surely. At some point. Can I lock it down again? Will it work? Peep show. Lockdown. Okay. No, he's standing in front of a bloody... Do you know what I'm going to do? Let's see if this works. See if it makes any difference. No, none. Okay. This is now beyond frustrating. I don't know what else I can do. I don't want to think about what that wheelchair's for. Nothing in here. Oh, what's this? Oh, I've seen that already. Oh, come on. There isn't anything else in here. Right. He's still out of it from the blood drain. What am I gonna do? What am I gonna do? He hasn't come round yet. I don't know how long he stays in that daze for. But I can't get in here. So obviously, they won't open that door until he's gone. Now, that's locked down. No one else can see. Okay, I've had enough. I've had enough. I don't know why my... Oh, there it is. It worked this time. It wouldn't draw the weapon. I'm just going to take him out. Jack's had enough. He's annoyed with Flynn upstairs. He's annoyed with this guy. Done. Close the door. Oh, put the weapon away. Someone, she's out. Excellent, it worked.
Yeah, what are you looking for, honey?
Me and you in a private room for 10 minutes. What do you think?
Okay, $200 for 10 minutes. Anything you want, you just gotta make it quick, all right?
Whoa, that's a lot of money. Do I have 200? I'm not even sure I do. Oh, damn. I'm gonna try it. Fine, here's the money.
All right. Just meet me in the Pleasure Palace, the room at the back of the hall. Your time just started.
Right, right. I'll go and be there. I'll meet you there in a second. There's the one I want. After you. happens. Okay, she should be out of it for a little while. Now, we are going after Chastity. Better save. Oh! Where did that sword come from, Chastity? Come on. Oh, after all that, we die. Chastity's a bit harder than we thought. Okay, right. You're still gonna die, Chastity. Right, here we go. Let's buff up first. Come on, Jack. Take her out. Quickly. Done. Oh. Oh, we weren't meant to be seen. She's seen us. We have a nice sword, though. Let's just get out. Let's get out. Looks like we made a mess of it again, Jack, but the job's done. The job is done. Right, let's go and see a Velvet Velour. Yep. Jack has no patience. None at all. Vesuvius. Okay. We weren't meant to kill anyone, and we did, and there weren't meant to be any witnesses, and there was. So, yep. Look, Jack was asked to kill someone. He's done it. That's the way he sees it. Job done. People are too fussy.
Look who's back.
Yep. Velvet.
That's Miss Velour to you.
Whatever. About that hunter. Stop that. Yeah, Hunter's dead.
I asked you not to kill anyone else.
Yeah, but...
You may be able to wash that blood off your hands easily, but my conscience will soak in it. Have you already forgotten your humanity? Because I haven't.
Yeah, maybe I didn't have any anyway. Look, so a few kind got in the way. You're okay, that's all that matters. The guy wouldn't leave. What was I meant to do?
Collateral damage, expendable losses, acceptable casualties, disgusting euphemisms. Hunters are soldiers. They know they're at war. But the kine, their lives have been wonderful. But now they're gone.
Honestly, the guy I killed, I'm pretty sure he was a miserable bastard anyway. I had a question. Stop that. Do you know anything, right, about a snuff film?
No. Are you into that kind of thing?
No, God, no. Just look, it's another job. Oh, God. I don't want to ask you about yourself because you're just going to me. Are you going to tell me anything more about yourself? All right, that's it. I'm done. Just...
Poor David Hatter.
What's you talking about? Who the hell is David Hatter?
David Hatter's an aspiring screenwriter and hotel manager.
Okay.
He comes in more often than he would admit. Several years now. Poor dear just can't get a break. I overheard him talking about his new screenplay with one of my girls.
Okay.
It was about secret societies and creatures that found themselves dealing with inner beasts and persecution by elder monsters. Sound reminiscent of something to you?
Yeah, he's writing a movie about the Bush administration, right?
No. It's about Kindred. The details of his story were too insightful to be coincidental. I think someone's working with David. A kindred who doesn't realize the consequences of their actions. Do you know what the penalty for revealing ourselves to kine is?
I don't know what. No Christmas bonus?
Death. I'm afraid poor David's big break. The screenplay he's worked so hard on must be destroyed. And his less than silent partner must be... executed. I know David too well. I'm very fond of David, and I'm too close to do what needs to be done.
Okay, I get it. You want me to kill Hatter and his source, right?
No! I don't think Hatter knows his collaborator is Kindred. You'll have to take David's screenplay, and somehow you'll have to coax the name of his source out of him. Once you've found out who, kill the traitor. But do not touch David.
Look, sounds like a problem of yours you're trying to pawn off on me here. Can't I just kill Hatter?
If you so much as touch a hair on David's precious, creative head, I will never speak to you again.
All you say is, anyway. Look, I was just throwing it out there. Fine. I'll do it your way.
David works at the Lucky Star Motel. He's very passionate about his writing. He loves to talk about his craft. I'm sure he'll talk about his screenplay. It may take some persuasion to get him to give up his collaborator's name, however.
Okay, look, fine. I better get some information from you after all of this.
After this is over, I promise you'll have my complete attention.
Right, no more mhms, right? I'll be back. Okay. How did I manage to turn around there without turning around? Okay, Lucky Star Motel it is. That's bathrooms. Maybe I could buy a t-shirt. Actually, I'm only half joking there. I need to find some new clothes. These ones stink. Maybe I should try out that pawn shop. Right. Fast, let's check out Fastbox, see if I can buy some clothes in here. What, is there no way in here either? Are all these front doors just for show? Okay. What's Red Spot? Beer, wine, tobacco. Let's go check it out anyway. They might have something. At least they have a working door.
Is out, everyone's in dreamland, and you've turned into the dead of night.
Oh.
Nobody to fall asleep next to? Go ahead and pull the radio into bed.
Favorite radio DJ.
And hey, why don't you call me sometime? Area code 323.
Nope, this is just all stuff that's no use to me whatsoever. I thought they might have had some clothes of some kind, but nope.
So caller, why aren't you?
Let's ask around.
What's up? Oh. Welcome to Red Spot, home of the Monstro Chug. 72 ounces of your favorite beverage for 89 cents. Blah, blah. You need help or something?
Yeah, sounds like you love working here, man. Don't you know? Anything going on around here? Exciting or unusual?
Oh, food have.
You should come out and see my band, A Bowl of Cereal. We're playing tomorrow night. Crematorium. $5. You drink men. We're going to ruin the place.
Dude talking behind me needs to shut up. Look, I'm looking for a tape.
You mean like hardcore girl on girl on kangaroo action and stuff?
Whoa!
Yeah, my man Flynn at the Sin Bin hooks me and my crew up for all the stuff they don't even allow on the internet, though.
Yeah, this is more of a snuff tape, you know?
I wonder how they microwave burritos in the Middle Ages.
I assume you do sleep. I heard this one guy like died right after watching it.
And what exactly do you do?
Yeah, I don't believe that people die after watching it. But look, do you know where I can get a copy?
Like I said, Flynn's a man. You should talk to him.
Yeah, he's not very talkative. Anything else I should know about?
Yeah, the Vesuvius rocks. They don't let me in.
I have to dip these potato chips in something.
It's like midget smuggling. Movies I might have
seen. Yeah, like, not my thing.
Hey, you know, you should really ask me about the special, you know?
Look, I'm no longer here. Goodbye.
All the world is one big video game.
That guy on the radio is wrecking my head. I gotta get out of here. Can't hear myself think. Okay. What's the state of play? David Hatter, he's at the Lucky Star Motel. We need to go there. And I need to talk to more people about the complete version of the snuff film. So, let's go Am I gonna try your man again? I was also looking for clothes, wasn't I? Which I can't seem to find anywhere. Okay, here's the motel. It's here, so we might as well. We might as well head in. Very nice. This is actually quite cozy. Good evening.
Sorry, no vacancies.
I'm looking for a guy. David Hatter?
Writer's such a tarnished term, you know what I mean? It's like every other guy says he's a writer, right? Like, you write a letter, you're a writer, you know? It's like, what I do, that's screenwriting. Like, I encapsulate the essence of excellent film in my scripts, all right? Like, I'm like a blacksmith with pens, all right? I'm a welder of montage.
Yeah, do you put the word like in all of your scripts, like, a million times as well, like, man? Look, what do you write?
Does a writer write, or does he just, like, ink the flotsam and jetsam floating in his subconscious into a 120-page piece of film genius? But, you know, most of my subconscious is filled with old horror films, so that's what I write mostly, I guess.
Horror, okay. What kind of horror film are you working on?
Me? I'm, like, looking to redefine the vampire movie, okay? Like, tons of people make vampire flicks, okay, popular characters, but me, I'm going to be doing the real deal. Like, not only is it going to be scary, but it's going to be, like, it's going to be believable.
Okay, sounds interesting. Do you have a copy of your script around here?
A good writer always does in this town. Hey, you in the business? Because, man, I got tons of ideas for movies. In fact, I should give you one of my completed screenplays. This one's still a work in progress.
No, I'm going to need... I like your ideas, man. I need all the copies of your vampire script.
Hey, man, there's only one copy here right now. I like to keep it pure. I don't even work on a computer. It disrupts the flow, you know?
Look, give it to me. I'll take a finger for every minute you keep it from me.
Huh? What? Are you joking? You're gonna rob my screenplay? Come on! What are you gonna do, cross my name out and put your own? What the hell?
Damn it, do not make me kill another person for asking questions tonight.
All right, here.
Thank you. Now, did you have any collaborators?
I really can't talk about it. He likes his privacy.
Look, here's my offer. I'm going to say this simply. You get to keep your eyes if you tell me.
His name? He goes by Julius. That's all I know. I'm supposed to meet him tonight. He's just a weird beach bum under the Santa Monica Pier. Man, why are you doing this to me?
Oh, well, look, I like the sound of your work, man, you know? That's all it is. Thanks for your cooperation, David. And remember, just about all this, yep. Shh. Nice and quiet, you know? Damn. Maybe I should get a bit pissed off more often. Just scare people rather than killing them. That went kind of well. Now, so we need to head to Santa Monica Pier and find someone called Julius. Have we met him already?
Hey there, need a date?
Was he one of the guys that we already spoke to? I don't know. Okay, taxi means quick save. Hey, dude.
Need a ride?
I do indeed. Take me to Santa Monica.
Lovely evening.
Yeah, dude, that's all you ever say. Right, where's the pier? Santa Monica. Feels like it's been a while. Beach access, this is what we want. Julius, oh Julius, wherefore art thou, Julius? Am I going the right way? Am I getting lost? Beach access. Oh, another sewer, great. And I'm stuck. What am I stuck on? Invisible things. Okay. B- back to the beach. Now, is this under the pier? It looks like it. Okay, well, the whole rest of the crowd have gone. Just this dude.
What do you want?
You Julius?
No.
Look. What have you been telling Immortal about us?
Please, I don't understand what I am. I didn't know.
Oh dear. Julius. Do you realize what pain you put me through? Also, you're getting a lot of people hot and bothered. Yeah? Do you know what the penalty is, Julius? Do you know?
I'm so sorry. Please. I'll never do it again.
You know what, right? You won't do it again. The punishment, Julius, is death.
No. Oh, God.
Look, they're not my rules, dude. You understand? I'm just getting used to this myself. I've got to do what I've got to do.
Please, find your heart. Please, find your heart.
Look, how the hell did you survive this long? Look, this is the end.
Oh, God. No.
Just... Julius, look, we're all pawns in the game without rules. I'll do it quick, right? I promise. Well, wasn't lying about the quick. Job done. Let's have a quick look at this screenplay. Can I actually read it? Oh, I've got this as well. Oh, something else. I need a research skill of at least 8 to use it. Loads of items. I need to think about what I'm going to do with these. Do I continue through the game not being able to do them? And do I have another option of paying for someone to do it for me? That's something I need to think about. Because I don't see Jack's character as being a researchy type character. But also, if it's game breaking, then I may have to if there aren't any other options. So I'll have to think about that one. Screenplay. Envelope with David Hatter's screenplay. It is tentatively titled Humanity versus the Vampire Lords. Okay, I can't read it or do anything with it. I just have it. Right, let's go and back and see Miss Valour. And she better stop in me. So, here we are back in Holywood. Now, which way is Vesuvius? It is this way. Velvet Valour. We bring good tidings. Human's starting to talk like a bloody vampire. This is all strange. And I still can't get any new clothes.
Look who's back.
Velvet.
That's Miss Valour to you.
Yeah. About Hatter.
Mm-hmm.
Here's his screenplay.
Oh, I suppose I should just tear it up. But I can't. I can't rip up the product of that man's soul. Here, would you tear it up for me?
Yeah, sure.
Thanks.
And I also found out the name of his source.
Are they? I mean, did you?
Look, it's taken care of.
It must have been difficult.
Not really.
But take some comfort in knowing if you hadn't, someone else would have had to. I do appreciate your help. A lot.
Yeah, it's How much, though, Velvet? You keep mm-hmming me. That's all I seem to get.
I'm willing to ignore the incredible lengths you've gone to be an asshole.
I suppose that's fair. Look, I got another question.
Mm-hmm.
It's really, really. Are you going to tell me about yourself now?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, right, I'm gone. I'm done. Why do I do these things? Why can't I remember who I am, where I came from? I remember bits. It's all vague. It's all fuzzy. I'm running around as a vampire, speaking to vampires, killing people. Yeah, I'm sort of enjoying that aspect of it, if I'm really honest. But, yeah, something's not quite right, man. Something's not quite right. What the hell? Where the hell? What am I meant to be doing now? I need to talk to more smut peddlers. Right, let's go back and see Flynn. See if we can get him to talk. Flynn.
What can I do for you, Slick?
You can stop calling me Slick. I got some questions.
Yeah? What do you want to know?
Look, Death Miles Productions. Can you give me something? Anything?
Forget it, man. I don't even know what the hell you're talking about. Huh? What? Who are they? Seriously, get the hell out of here.
I need to go and check the cash situation. How much cash do I have? I don't even have 500. I'm going to have to get the money. There's nothing downstairs. I've taken the money out of the machine down there already. I need to find someone or something to rob. Or to get some paying work. What are my other quests? Do I have anything elsewhere? Downtown, that's... Prince wants the sarcophagus now. First step, find Gary. Yeah, I can't find Gary because Isaac won't help me until I get this bloody tape. Hollywood is looking for the tape. Chinatown we haven't been to. Santa Monica. Oh, mail the werewolf blood to LaCroix. Check her email for some reward. Okay, I need to go back home to see if LaCroix has given me any payment for that. Okay, let's do that. That's what we need to do. Let's head back home.
It's a nice night out, huh?
The one thing I will say is whatever deal the Camarilla has with the taxi companies, it's quite handy not having to pay for them. Okay, we need to head to the other side. Whoa!
Lovely
what the
evening.
Hell is going on here? Ow! Who the hell is this? And why is she attacking me? That's not on. Oh, why are you attacking me? Right, run, Jack. Run. I don't get it. I get attacked, and the cop attacks me. Why wouldn't he go down the sewer? I am down the sewer. God. What the hell happened there? Police are still hunting for me. And I won't move. We just need to hide out. Might as well find some rats while we're down here. Who the hell was that? Why did she attack? And why did the police attack me for defending myself? That's what I want to know. Okay, good. Coast is clear. Come on. Let's see where this one brings us out. That was a little unexpected. Looks like she's hurt me as well. I'm gonna see if I can take any of these pills to see if they actually do anything. Okay. Yeah, I'm on the wrong side. Anyway, try these pills. Can't use. Well, might as well sell them then at this point. They don't seem to do anything. Don't tell me this. No, it's not. Home is around here somewhere. There we go. I need enough money to take me over the 500 because it looks like I'm going to have to pay Flynn for this information, because otherwise, oh, I'll get the money. I'm going to hope there's money. You better be bloody paying me for that. Where, what I had to go through to get that werewolf blood. 150. A wad of money left lying around. Funny that. Nice. So I now have 635. So back to Hollywood. Maybe try some other places. Ask around a bit more and then pay Flynn the money if I absolutely have to. Given that scumbag cash, this is something I want to do. Hopefully I get the opportunity to maybe rob him and take it back later on. Okay. Let's find a taxi. Right. Let's ask around some more. We haven't been into the asp hole. Let's see if anyone in here knows anything about a tape. Said if I can avoid paying Flynn, that's my plan. Whoa, got the whole samurai look going there, dude. You?
It's not my problem.
Oh, hello. Someone seems to have just left.
Lovely evening.
Dude, get out of the way. Someone's left something up there. And it's mine. What was it? I have a what? It looks like a class ring. Go North Brea Tech Iguanodons. What the hell? Okay, I've got pills. I've got three watches. The faceplate says Quantum Limited Edition. It's kind of watch that comes with its own matching luxury vehicle. Okay, pawn shop after I've asked around in here, and we can get some more cash. No one in here wants to talk.
Not today.
You? No. Oh, finally.
Do I know you?
Why? What do you want?
I'm not gay, but I'm willing to learn.
Okay.
Do I know you?
No, it's... Yeah, hold that thought. Okay, very odd.
I don't think so.
It's a nice night out, huh?
Oh. I like this song. Was that saying I could dance? Go, Jack. Jack's only doing this to see if someone will actually talk to him. Yep, Jack getting into it. Right, well, one of them talked to him now.
Hey there, need a date?
Lovely evening.
Okay. Nope, no one wants to talk to me.
What do you want?
Maybe you're familiar with my work. The crowd shot of
this bathroom.
Background zombie and zombie Montessori. Any dick.
food.
That's the exit. No.
Hypothetical question.
Let's try upstairs.
Do you think it would be okay to sleep with the producer?
Okay.
If he would give you a part in his next movie?
Hollywood talk. Oh, hello. And you might be?
I just might.
Seriously, who are you?
Why don't you ask everyone else in the world? They'd know.
Yeah, what the hell's your problem, dude?
Never mind.
Look, just tell me who you are.
Why don't you ask everyone else in the world? They'd know.
Come on, tell me.
Ash, there. Go tell your friends so they don't bug me.
Okay. Ash? I've never met a celebrity before, you know?
I bet.
So, Ash, do you know anything about a snuff film?
That's street trash. You want the sin bin. What? Anything else?
Why does everything keep sending me to the sin bin? Anyway, your movies suck. You can't act for dog balls.
Your opinion means so much to me.
Keep it up, pretty boy. You won't look pretty no more.
What's the catch?
Oh, dearie me. You have a death wish or something, man?
To say yes would be an understatement. What do you care anyway? I could just do it. Just walk out of here and into a legend. Maybe I live, maybe I don't. What's the difference?
Dude, you are taking too many drugs and you're not making any sense at all.
You didn't see them?
See who?
Hunters in front, back, inside my club. I try to leave, they'll move on. So I had to ask myself, if I go out there, am I prepared to die? How many could I take out before the killing stroke, huh? Two? Three? I could just walk out there, right now, blaze of glory, the end. And you know what? Knowing that, it doesn't bother me. And I guess the only reason I haven't walked out yet is because I'm trying to figure out why it doesn't bother me.
Dude, you're a vampire. Why didn't you say so? Maybe I can help.
Did Isaac send you?
You know Isaac.
Isaac's a gnarled old tree that wrapped its roots around the city years ago. He's a relic of an age long since past. He thinks he gave me everything I have. But all he gave me was a curse.
So, you don't really like Isaac then?
That story would take too long to tell. Suffice it to say, we haven't seen eye to eye on too many things lately. And it's pissed Isaac off to no end.
For instance?
He kept saying I should keep a low profile. He kept saying I was attracting too much attention to myself.
And what's wrong with keeping a low profile? You're a vampire, dude.
You don't know me. I can't sit in an office all day and play Hollywood from the shadows. That's Isaac's thing. I'm an actor. I was an actor. I don't have anything anymore except this club and some fame and this curse.
You don't like being, you know, vampire?
I didn't ask you this. I didn't ask Isaac to save my life. Maybe I wanted to die. I was having fun, damn it. I was alive. Who the hell gave him the right to deny me that? I can't act anymore. I can't love anymore. All I can do is fade into obscurity.
So, dude, you want fame. Fame is more to you than immortality. That's interesting, dude. But maybe I can help.
Did Isaac send you?
No, he didn't. I'm just here.
What the hell, then, would be your motivation to help me?
Because you sort of talk shit, but you're kind of interesting as well. You know? And your club plays some good music. And also, you know, money, and I know you've got some.
Fine, I've got drawers of the stuff. My life's so goddamn easy because of it. So, how do you get me out of here to cash in?
Um, You could switch clothes with someone in the club who looks like you.
Did you get that idea from a sitcom? Whatever. Look around the club. Maybe you'll get lucky.
Yeah, you leave with me. I'll go find someone. Where the hell do I get someone who looks like him? Or similar? What does he look like? Yep, he's got that whole...
Hey, need a date?
The whole Rob Lowe thing going on. While I'm here, anyone else that I can talk to? No. No other doors. No, that's it. That's fine. So what did my quest log say? You've off to help Ash avoid the hunters by convincing a lookalike to switch clothes with him. Okay. This dude, would he do? Oh, hello. Hello, Mr. Rob Lowe, too.
Jordan.
Do I one know you?
Hey, you're feet. Ash, aren't you? Yeah, just like...
No. Sorry, I think you've confused me for someone else.
Look, you just... You look just like him. Would you mind... I know this is going to sound a bit weird, dude, but would you mind taking off your clothes for me?
Ah! Ew, I'm not that drunk. Yikes.
Look, I need your clothes. Give them to me now.
Whoa, back up. What the hell do you want my clothes for?
Look, I want to give your clothes to the real Ash.
What am I supposed to wear?
Yep. You see... That guy over there, you get to wear his clothes.
This is crazy. This is... Oh, I knew I should have gone to Glaze tonight. All right, I'll do it. What do you want me to do?
Okay, go wait in the men's bathroom. Change clothes with the guy who looks like you. Straightforward enough?
Story.
Good, he's going to the bathroom. Now, if I get the real Ash... Dude,
you got the clothes.
Yeah, go into the men's bathroom, change clothes with the guy in there. Seriously, dude, he looks just like you.
You better hope they get these hunters from the temp agency, because all the pro's gonna do is have a laugh. If it works, I'm out of this city. Here, token of my thanks.
$250. Dude, it will be well spent. Good job. Okay, what have we got? You were successful in your attempt to fool Ash's hunters by having Ash change clothes with some poor chump. A success. Jack, we are having a good night, I think. Best night we've had in a while. Apart from being attacked by some crazy woman with a fire stick. Whatever that was all about. All in all, it's going pretty well, I have to say. Oh, the samurai guide is a hunter. And he just killed the poor chump. Yeah, out of here. Okay. I have plenty of cash now. I'm still reluctant to give it to Flynn. So I'm going to ask around a bit more before we go back to him. A few more places we haven't been into that we can ask around. But I think we will continue our search, our asking around, in the next episode. Thank you all very much for watching. It's much appreciated. Thank you for being with me. And I hope you're all well. And until next time, take care.